We will solve the problem on the charge distribution when there are three concentric spheres and the inner sphere is given plus Q charge, outer is given minus Q, and the middle sphere is earthed. We have to find what will be the charge distribution on these spheres after this arrangement. So for solving such problems, 3 points. Point number one, the charges on the isolated, I repeat, the isolated spheres will remain conserved. So it will be total charge on this will remain plus Q, total charge on this remain minus Q. So isolated bodies, total charge remains same. Number two, the electric field inside any conducting body is zero, and apply the Gaussian surface E dot ds, integral is Q upon E zero, and take E as zero because electric field inside a conducting surface is zero. And third point is, when earthing is done, the potential of that sphere will be zero. So with these 3 points we can solve this problem. Now take first the sphere B. It's a thin sphere, but even thin will have some thickness. Let this be the sphere. Let me draw it like this. This is the sphere B. Take a Gaussian surface inside the walls of the sphere B. There is a plus Q charge inside. This is the Gaussian surface, and electric field here has to be zero because it is a conductor. So E dot ds is equal to Q net upon E zero. Since this is zero, means Q net enclosed in this Gaussian surface has to be zero. So if I placed QA here and QB here, so QA is equal to minus Q. That is one part. So minus Q will appear here, and this we don't know. Let this be QB. Now take the sphere C and apply the same principle. The sphere C, and I am drawing magnified view so that we can draw the Gaussian surface. So it's a thin sphere, but thin will also have some thickness. So this is the Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. And what are the charges inside? So far, if we move outwards, the charges inside was plus Q, minus Q, plus QB. These were the charges. Plus Q, minus Q, plus QB inside. Let there be a charge QC here. And what will be this QC? Take a Gaussian surface. Electric field inside this conductor is zero. So E dot ds is equal to zero, means Q net is zero. So what is Q net? Plus Q, minus Q, plus QB, plus QC is equal to zero. So QC is equal to minus QB. So here the charge will be minus QB. Now what will be the charge on the outer side? Because the total charge is conserved, minus QB has come here, so plus QB has to be here, so that the total charge on this sphere doesn't change. Now the basic groundwork is done. Just find potential at this point. Potential at B will be, V at B would be V due to A at B plus V due to B at B, and V due to C at B. Now, what is V due to C at B? What is the charge here? The total charge here is minus Q. So, V B due to C is equal to total charge is minus Q upon 4 pi E0, and you have to take this distance. Even if you are finding potential at B, distance has to be C, because for a sphere the potential inside is constant. For a shell, potential is like this. If this is the radius A, potential inside will be same as potential on this surface. Potential on this surface is minus Q upon 4 pi E0 C. Same potential will appear here. So this is the potential 1. Then what is the potential of B due to B? B due to B would be, what is the total charge here? Minus Q plus QB upon 4 pi E0 divided by B. What is potential of A at B? For outside this sphere, as I showed, potential will be like this. So at any radius, you have to apply that radius. So here radius is B. So VA at B is equal to Q upon 4 pi E0 B. Now add these three and they are equal to 0. So it becomes, this will get cancelled, this part will get cancelled. So you will get minus Q upon C plus QB upon B is equal to 0. This is the relationship we are getting. So QB is equal to Q into B upon C. That is the value of charge appearing here. So it will be Q into B upon C, and here it will be minus Q into B upon C, and here it will be Q minus Q plus Q into B upon C. So this solves the problem. Thank you.